So, as I was saying, this is a practice in metta or loving kindness or compassion, whatever you want to think is the right term for you today. And all we're doing at the moment is just arriving, setting ourselves up for the practice, just allowing our mind and body just to settle a little bit. And again, just coming back to sort of what we were discussing before, you know, this idea about compassion is also that, you know, it's not about feeling guilty about place times when you could have been, or people you could have been more compassionate to. It's about receiving their warmth, I guess, is a good way of looking at it, that they can in turn give and receive compassion in a much more open and accepting way, that we're not to feel guilty about things we could have done better or times that we could have tried harder or people that have given us more than we've given. So we're just diving into that sort of shamatha work, that calm abiding. Even checking into our posture. Even just noticing the quality of our breath at the moment. It's that idea of how are we breathing right now? So maybe you're utilizing words like calm and ease, or that recognition that we're breathing and just saying in, as we're breathing out, just saying out. Maybe you're just gently bringing your attention to different parts of the body or sounds that are happening around you. Just letting distractions happen. Not trying to block or stop or get rid of. choosing the quality of our breath or our posture or sounds, sensations in the body to reconnect us back into presence. That these areas of attention can really just I want to say the word drag, but it helps us to feel a little bit closer to being. Let go of any idea of trying to meditate, or go of any expectations of what you want to get out of this practice, and truly arrive. Just arrive, noticing how you're feeling, noticing how the world around you feels to you. I suppose if there was a reason why we take time out every day just to settle our mind, often sometimes it doesn't feel like it settles, but it's just to allow us to look a little closer into things, to be less reactive. As the mind settles, even if you want to just imagine yourself like that metaphor we used the other day of letting the pond settle, that's all we're doing, just sitting and watching patiently. We use our breath or body or sounds as our reminder, our mindfulness. We don't need to try and make the pond still. We don't need to forcefully or often belligerently create a slower, stable or calmer mind. That if we just watch it gently, it'll settle all on its own. It never matters how well you're doing. There's nothing to compare yourself against other than this moment. We just do our best. So our practice in Metta is just about bringing attention to people or animals, fauna and flora, I should say, in our lives. That often a lot of them had no intention of benefiting us, but we received it anyway. That maybe it was purely selfish act in what they do and how they work, but we were still receive their kindness. And so this practice is about receiving that and just wishing for them that same warmth, extending compassion and kindness and gratitude. Just remembering that informed process, that if it ever gets too much, you have the permission to stop, to wander away. You also have the permission to lie down or sit back up again, to do the practice walking. That you are always in control. So we're just going to do 5 really focused calming breaths, and I hope they're calming. And by this I mean just nice deep breaths in, and I really want you just to let the out breath just go out long and slow as you can, almost twice as long as your breath in. So you're breathing in, taking in as much as your body needs, and then breathing out, just letting that breath go long and slow. I just want you to do 5, if you want to do 4 or 6, I'm not counting. But just breathing in, and all slowly breathing back out again, and just letting your body relax a little bit more into your posture as you're breathing out. So you're breathing in, knowing that you're breathing in. Breathe out. Just let go, let the shoulders soften, the hands soften, the posture soften, the mind soften. You to realize that you can come back to those types of breaths as well throughout the practice. If they want to be your anchor, please use them. And then just returning your breath back to that normal rhythm once you've done those breaths. And we're going to begin by turning our attention towards our loved ones. Now for this particular type of practice, we can either focus on one person or many. If you don't have a loved one now, maybe you did, or it's an animal. I just want you to give a couple moments and just contemplate, why are these people so wonderful in your life? What kindness have you received from them? Maybe they encouraged you when you were down or worried. Maybe they helped by just being with you in those moments of sadness or frustration or happiness. Maybe it's just the little things that they do or did that just made you feel like they wanted you in their life. And while whilst you're bringing this person or people to mind, I just want you to see if you can just let your heart hold some of that warmth that they've shown you, some of that kindness that you've received from them. Just letting that warmth touch your heart if you can. Maybe this person was a family member or a friend. And not all of us had the most amazing parents. But without the love of someone that maybe stepped in and helped, we wouldn't be where we are today. There was someone that fed us and kept us warm at nights. They clothed us, helped us get to school. That there has to have been one or two people at least that have loved you enough to get to where you are now. If you think about how many sleepless nights you've had, how many times you were sick and you're cared for. And if you're a parent right now, maybe you can even recognize how hard it is being a parent. That these people have taught us how to speak and communicate. They got us to school and to sport, friends' homes. That your loved ones and friends, they give up so much of their own time to help you to understand, to grow. That a lot of what we've learned in our lives have come from expensive. Many of these people's lives, and it's just wonderful to realize this and feel this. Just thinking about some of the little things that they did. And even for those that have had pets, animals, when I think of unconditional love, I often think of my dog. I have wonderful kids and wonderful parents and a wonderful wife. Just thinking about those people that have been there for you, and let that touch your heart if you can. And even if you wanted to, sending back some thanks. If you're bringing them to mind, this could be a wonderful opportunity, whether they're still around us or not, just to remind them that they mattered in your life. And why they did. And I can promise you one thing, that all this wonderfulness that you're feeling about these people, they felt the same about you too. That you were someone that deserved their love, deserved their tenderness, deserved their nurturing, deserved their warmth, and deserved their time. That out of everyone in the world, they wanted to share all of that with you. Because maybe they know something about you that not even you know. That at the core of who you are is a caring and kind human. Just letting that touch your heart if you can. And then just coming back to your breath. Just noticing the quality of your breath. Getting a sense of the connection, the sensations in the body and the sounds that are around you. Just resting a few moments at that monstrous organ right in the middle of our chest, the heart of ours. The next person I want to bring your focus to is the person that you were just briefly talking to on that call. I just want you to bring them into your thoughts. You're just imagining them sat there. Maybe they've gone through some struggles and some difficulties in their life. Maybe they're going through ones right now. Maybe it's the same as you, maybe it's different. I just want you to connect into your heart. Just get a real sense of what they feel, what you feel they need right now. And maybe you want to put some words into that sense of connection. And truly wishing them well. Maybe you can use the old phrases, the Metta phrases of may you be happy and healthy, may you be free from harm, free from suffering. Maybe you want to use your own phrases. And I'll just offer up a couple of my own. There's a real underlying hope, a real wish. That you find peace in this world. That you let go of the shackles of a society that breeds comparisons and competition, creating anxiety and frustration. May you truly find the causes of suffering and the causes of happiness. May you be truly at peace with yourself. You're just really wishing, sending that warmth and nurturing towards that other. A real sense of really wanting to find their place in this world. May you truly be at ease. And just imagining that other person receiving your thoughts and hopes and wishes. And even taking it a little bit further and just seeing them successful in their jobs. Enjoying relationships, being nurtured, and even just seeing them truly being at peace, being at ease, being at what you hope for them to be, just that. Maybe there's a sense of calmness that comes to them now. And just imagining for them what that might feel like. What that might look like. And seeing them being happy and fulfilled. As we just let go of that person and just come back to our breath a few moments. Again, just noticing the quality of our breath, how our posture is, the sounds of the world that's around us. And if you're feeling like it, just taking a couple of those calming breaths, just deep, meaningful, and just let it go slow, steady. Just resting into your posture again. Again, just bringing our focus into our hearts. One more, we have two more times, or three, or four. We're just resting our attention into our hearts. I just want you to bring some focus to those people that we don't really know. Those that transport our food, work in petrol stations, our doctors and nurses and teachers, driving our buses, working on farms, mining. And recognizing the truly interdependent nature of our world. That without all of these people, we couldn't live or thrive. That they may never have had us in their thoughts at all, but we received their kindness. And I just want you to imagine them all receiving everything they need to make their lives happy. Maybe it is wealth, homes, to be loved by someone truly and deeply. And so when we wish them happiness, wish them free from suffering, we can just imagine what that might be like for them. Whilst we don't need to visualize it, we know what it would feel like to be safe, to have our own home, to feel completely at ease in our lives. I just want you to imagine these people as they flick through our mind, these transporters of our food, road workers, librarians, ferry workers, hospitality workers. All these people make such a difference in our lives every day. And this is just our time just to appreciate that. And sending them warmth, seeing them be successful in their lives, looking after their families, going away on holidays, connecting with their gods, whatever it is. And then just when you're ready, just letting go of these people from your thoughts. And just coming back to our breath again and noticing that we're breathing. noticing the quality of our breath, our posture. And second to last are those people that haven't spent their time helping us. In fact, a lot of the times they've harmed us. Maybe they were jealous of us, frustrated by us, maybe they felt insecure. And our immediate response is often, how do we be kind to these people? Often when we look a little closer at ourselves, we can see these people have actually made us stronger. They challenged us. They pushed us to change. They got us out of our comfort zone at times. Even if the process at that time may not have been as positive as you hoped, we learned and grew. Maybe it was whatever happened led us to reaching out in our community, learning new ways to look after ourselves. Maybe it even pushed us into helping others, getting into roles in care and charitable works. If we could, maybe we could take it even a little bit further and just recognize that these people weren't born with the want to hurt. That it's through their own suffering, their own ability to manage their suffering, but often these people helped us to be patient, to be kind, to be strong, diligent. Often these types of people have helped us to grow even more than our loved ones have at times. And so some of these strengths have, in a roundabout way, come at their expense. If we could feel into our hearts and sending some warmth and kindness towards these people that have hurt us or harmed us, not as a form of forgiveness, but just as a hope that they stop hurting the people that are around them. That maybe you could just imagine that they find the role model that they need. They find the love of their life. They get the job that they always deserved, feel secure. Maybe they find out about compassion, find peace in themselves through religion or find a deeper spiritual understanding of themselves so they stop hurting you or anyone else in the future. And I just want you to imagine them, if you can do, imagine them happy. Imagine them content. Imagine them at ease with their world, because that ease goes on to help everyone else, including you. it doesn't mean forgiving them. You're just hoping for positive change. Even if your mind wants to tell you there's no way they could change. And then just letting go of that person or people. And just returning gently back to our breath again. Again, just noticing the quality of our breath. Getting in contact with the sensations felt in the body. Becoming aware of the sounds. Own time, becoming aware of the world that's around you, the colours and the shapes. And just taking another 30 seconds just to gently rest, even with your eyes open, just into your heart. Taking a few moments just to reflect on how you found that type of practice. Did you find it easy or difficult? Did you find yourself getting frustrated at times, or completely calm and settled and open?